Life is too short to try to have peace with people that don't want to have peace with you. Some of your relatives, you love them, but you have to love them from a distance. Don't frustrate yourself trying to make things happen that they don't want to happen. That's not being disrespectful. That's being responsible with the gifts God has given you. My nature is to be a peacemaker. I want everybody to be happy. I'll go the extra mile 400 times to make peace. But some people have their own issues. They don't get along with themselves. How are they going to get along with you? They don't like who they are. How are they going to like who you are? No matter what you do, it's not going to be enough. They're going to find fault, be critical, try to make you feel guilty. If you keep trying to appease them, keep bending over backwards, spending all your time and energy, all that's doing is letting them control you. Be nice, but don't get distracted trying to have peace with someone that doesn't want peace. We all have people in our life like David's brother. They don't like seeing you happy, rising higher, going places. It's not about you, it's about the favor on your life. It's about the blessing God put on you. Don't take it personally. Keep your face set. You won't fulfill your destiny if you're trying to keep everyone happy. Some people that make the most withdrawals put in the least deposits. They're high maintenance people. They expect you to always be there to help them, to encourage them, to meet their every demand. But when you need something, they're never around. They're too busy. If that friendship is one-sided, they're doing all the taking and none of the giving, you need to make a change. I've heard it said, quit swimming across an ocean to be good to someone that won't jump across a puddle to be good to you. If they get offended because you don't meet every expectation, they weren't a true friend. They just want you for what you can do for them. Those are distractions. You need to gradually break away from people like that. You were not created to be controlled, to never have any time to pursue what God put in your heart. But Joel, what if they get upset? What if I hurt their feelings? I would rather disappoint a few people than to disappoint God. Because when you come to the end of life, you won't give an account to people of what you did with your time, your talents, your resources. You'll give an account to God.